Hello, welcome to Maths with Jay.
We want to write down the Cartesian equation of the curve represented by these parametric equations. So all that means is that we need to eliminate the theta between these two equations. So we've got sine theta in the first equation and cos 2 theta in the second equation. So what we're doing here is we're thinking about what identity links cos 2 theta and sine theta. Well, cos 2 theta is the one that we can write in terms of sine theta, isn't it? So let's just write that down. Well, we know that cos 2 theta is 1 minus 2 sine squared theta. So let's just number our equations and have a look what we have to do. Well, we know that we can write cos 2 theta in terms of sine theta, so that means we want to use the first equation to write down sine theta. So equation 1 tells us that sine theta is x minus 4, just subtracting 4 from both sides. And then all we need to do is write down y in terms of sine theta. So equation 2, we know that y is equal to 1 minus, now cos 2 theta, we know, is 1 minus 2 sine squared theta. So let's just write that down here. And we can simplify that. So 1 minus 1 just cancels out, and then minus minus gives us a plus. So we know that y is simply 2 sine squared theta. But we know that sine theta is x minus 4, so that's equal to 2 x minus 4 squared. So there is our equation. You might like to expand the brackets if you want to, but really that will do. Another thing you might be interested in doing is sketching a graph. But remember, it's not enough just to look at this equation. You do need to think about what values sine and cos can take. Think about the minimum and maximum values they can take. We may like to substitute in some angles for the theta to help you with that.